But her sister Elizabeth is very agreeable.
Thoroughly tolerable, I dare say. To not have someone up to tempt me. So what do you recommend to encourage affection?
Dancing. If one's partner is barely tolerable.
Oh, I still can't believe what he said about you,
Mr. Darcy. I'd more easily forgive his vanity had he not wounded mine.
And of course, you must improve my mind by extensive reading.
I'm no longer surprised at your knowing only 6 accomplished women. I rather wonder now at your knowing any. Mr. Darcy.
Miss Elizabeth.
Would you consider pride a fault or a virtue?
That I couldn't say.
Doing our best to find a fault in you.
Maybe it's that I find it hard to forgive the follies and vices of others, or their offences against me. My good opinion, once lost, is lost forever.
Oh dear, I cannot tease you about that. What a shame, for I dearly love to laugh.
Stay with me,
Mr. Darcy.
A little longer.
What are you doing here?
And wine grows stronger, deeper than the truth.
May I have the next dance, Miss Elizabeth?
Why do you ask such a question?
To make out your character, Mr. Darcy.
And what have you discovered?
Very little. There are such different accounts of you as puzzling me.
I
know
that I die. I hope to afford you more clarity in the future.
I can't help but be wrong in the dark, 'cause I'm overcome in this war of hearts.
Why, with so evident a design of insulting me, you chose to tell me that you like me against your better judgment.
Perhaps it's best that I could have a look at not your pride be heard by my honesty in admitting scruples about our relationship. Did you expect me to rejoice in the inferiority of your circumstances?
And those are the words of a gentleman.